welcome students, family, faculty, and guests to the 50th annual Agriculture Banquet. It is no secret that this year was unprecedented for all of us. From online learning to the shutdown of industries, we have all had changes to adapt to. Despite all the uncertainty, Lakeland College agriculture students, instructors, and other college faculty have worked to make this year the best year possible.
We are excited to still celebrate all the amazing accomplishments that have been made by our agriculture students. We thank everyone for the enormous support that has been given throughout this year and every year. This year's banquet might look a little bit different, but we're excited to still be able to present this year's awards and recognition virtually. Thank you for tuning in, and we hope you enjoyed the program. Now I'll turn it over to Hannah Tappendorf to introduce the agriculture staff.
Thank you, McKenna. Today, I have the privilege of introducing you to our phenomenal Agriculture Division faculty. These 9 instructors lead tirelessly day in and day out to share their passions and to create opportunities for students. We applaud their dedication to all of us and to Lakeland College. Dyke Barkley, horticulture instructor. Brent Curry, John Deere Technology. Mark Niemerg, agriculture instructor. Ryan Orrick, agriculture division chair. Woody Reinhardt, ag power instructor. Matt Rogers, John Deere Technology. Hayden Wilder, agriculture instructor and livestock judging coach. And Ryan Wildman, agriculture instructor. I would also like to thank our administrative assistant for the agriculture division, Kathy Montgomery. In the agriculture division, we have many students who hold various leadership roles in clubs and organizations on and off campus. I would now like to welcome Tara Hummel to recognize those student leaders.
Thank you, Hannah. Many of the ag students at Lakeland are ambitious and have chosen to be involved in other organizations, teams, and clubs. I would now like to recognize these student leaders that have dedicated their time and efforts to these extracurriculars. Beginning with sports. Softball, Briah Black and Jordan Sapp. Baseball, Aaron Harrell. Our peer-to-peer, Ashton Geyer. Student Government Association members, Cassie Peters, J.C. Schertz, Bree Ulmer, Brooke Byers, and Sky Shoemaker. Our student ambassadors, McKenna Green, Catherine Smith, Hannah Tappendorf, and Emily Walk. The student representatives for the Alumni Board, Hannah Tappendorf and Cassie Peters. The president of the American Junior Red Angus Association, Paige Van Dyke. The State 4-H Livestock Ambassador Team, Paige Van Dyke, Sky Shoemaker, and Tanner Mickey. The State American Degree recipients, Cody Nodal and Tara Hummel. And now I'd like to welcome our division chair, Ryan Orrick, to make a few comments.
Thank you for joining us as we celebrate the achievements of our division and students. This marks the 50th year that Lakeland College has held an agriculture banquet. A milestone like 50 certainly brings a sense of nostalgia and appreciation for our history and tradition of excellence. I'm appreciative of all the past faculty members and students that have helped craft the Lakeland Ag Division into what it is today. And I would like to thank all of our current staff and ag students for representing this great tradition. We are proud of our students, and we are thankful to have been a small part of their journey and look forward to their future success. Here are just a few highlights of success of students within our division and milestones. The following students, Tyler Conlon, Michael Jones, Ryan Stark, Francis Heeman, Ariana Zavatsky, Abigail Logston, Alexis Elder, and Dalton Heavland. These students are a part of the United States military. I would like to thank them, all of the veterans, and active service members for their sacrifice for our freedom and the chance to belong to the greatest nation in history. Each year in the Ag Division, we are fortunate to work with some of the best and brightest talent. I would like to share some of these outstanding leadership and accomplishments. This can be seen in 23 of our students that have held or currently hold an FFA section office, with Emma Freebaron being the 2019 State FFA Secretary, and as well, Emma now serves as the Vice President of Illinois PAS. 60 of our students achieved the State FFA degree, 12 students have achieved their state proficiency, and we have two national proficiency winners, McKenna Green in grain production and Tara Hummel in small animal production. Three state star winners, McKenna Green, Illinois state star farmer, Tara Hummel, Illinois star placement, and the 2020 Illinois state star farmer, Tanner Mickey. The American FFA degree is one of the highest honors a student can achieve in their FFA career. We are proud to say that 10 of our students have achieved this honor. And I'd like to thank Ashton Geyer, our peer-to-peer for the Agriculture Division, for all of her work this year. Ashton is responsible for most all of our social media posts and the initiative of Throwback Thursday, which I know so many of you have enjoyed. Thanks, Ashton, for all of your help. To the freshman students, we have enjoyed working with you this year and look forward to your commitment of carrying on the tradition of excellence next year as sophomores. To the sophomores and certificate students, soon your time at Lakeland will be completed and it will be on to the next chapter. Thank you for representing the college in such a great way these last 2 years, and good luck on your future endeavors. We're thankful for the support of two past division chairs, Kurt Rinker and John Althouse. Vice President of Academic Services, John Althouse, will be awarding each GPA and program outstanding winner a $100 scholarship on behalf of his parents, the George and Lily Bell Althouse Memorial Fund. Kurt Rinker will award the outstanding student tonight a $500 scholarship. Thank you for your support. Lastly, I will announce the Agriculture Division Honored Alumnus winner. This year's recipient is Dr. Sean Castile. Dr. Castile is a 1999 graduate of our Ag Transfer program here at Lakeland College. After Lakeland College, Dr. Castile transferred to the University of Illinois and completed a bachelor's degree in crop science. Sean obtained his master's degree in crop science and PhD in soil science at North Carolina State University. In 2009, Sean began employment at Purdue University as the Extension Soybean and Small Grain Specialist. Congratulations, Dr. Sean Castile.
Hello, my name is Sean Castile. I'm the Extension Soybean Agronomist at Purdue University. This all started with the opportunity that I was given at Lakeland. I'm just a farm boy from East Central Illinois, a small school, Lovington High School, graduating class, 34 students. And, you know, I just want to be able to work at home at the farm and help farmers. And so Lakeland gave me a great opportunity to go to school for a couple more years after high school, work on the farm, and then really expose me to a lot of opportunities. And with that, I'm an introvert by nature, but my job as an extension agronomist is I talk to people all the time. Now it's more virtually than it has been in the previous years, like we are today, but Lakeland helps springboard me into be an extroverted introvert so then I can help growers, I can help farmers, I can help people. You know, my time there at Lakeland has just been a wonderful experience as I think back on the time that I was an ambassador with the program there, showing students around, potential students around campus, and figure out all the circles to, you know, going to the high schools, even going back to the high school where I did FFA and Ag and Sullivan, and going back to just share my experiences so others could have an opportunity. You know, that time with John Van Dyke and Jan Storm and just really helped, you know, give me an opportunity to stand on my own 2 feet, and the opportunity to speak in front of people, the opportunity to really advance and think what opportunities were there. And I think back to my classes with Mark Niemerg. I can think in particular about, you know, corn fixing its own nitrogen and some of the connections that he gave me with Southern Illinois, and the opportunity to have an internship that, you know, I just plan on going back to the farm. But, you know, my first summer had the opportunity to do a research experience, an internship, sales experience to see what I liked and what I didn't like, and really set the path for me moving forward. And then I think back about some of the other instructors there, from Kurt Rinker to Juergens and so many others, Pike, a lot of those guys I've actually interacted now in the recent years, just a wonderful family to be a part of. And I can't wait to come back and see how campus has changed. I've been trying to get back the last couple of years. It hasn't worked out, but I'd love to come back, see how campus has changed and what it's really meant for me. So I'm honored that I would even be considered for this award through the Division of Ag. And you know, Lakeland has done so much for me to be a springboard, again, to go from a small school, farm boy, and then the 3,000 to 6,000 student range, depending on, you know, where you're on campus or the extended campuses, and then go on to U of I and to go to North Carolina, for goodness sakes. I never even thought I'd get out of the state of Illinois. And so, again, I am very, very thankful for Lakeland, what it's done for me. And I know it's doing so much for the other students that are going now. And again, I'm just honored to be a part of that Laker Nation and to think back about that time, whether it's going back and shooting pool during breaks, the 30-minute drives back and forth, and a lot of the memories from the students and classmates, as well as the teachers, instructors, and advisors. Thank you again for this opportunity. I can't wait to come back and talk to you guys and see how things have changed, and maybe we can see about working together in the future. Thanks so much, and have a great spring, and hopefully everyone stays healthy and happy. God bless.
Well, hello, everyone. My name is Hayden Wilder, and I'm an agriculture instructor, the advisor of the Ag Production and Management major, and the livestock judging coach here at Lakeland College. And here for this portion of the program, I just want to take a little bit of time and introduce our livestock judging teams in the 2020-21 school year and give you a little bit of overview of some of their highlights and introduce you to some of those members. So I'll start off briefly just with our freshman team. And a freshman year here in terms of being a judging team member is very much about, first and foremost, getting acclimated to life away from home at college and transitioning in to that competitive judging schedule. And, you know, it goes without saying that this year has been challenging from a standpoint of having opportunities to compete and travel, but, you know, thankful for a lot of people in a lot of different settings that have made some, that have given these kids some chances this year. And I think one example of that would be Tree Lane Farms would have come together there in November and put together a really stellar contest for Illinois colleges here in the state this year. And this freshman team would actually have been the high team overall at that Tree Lane contest. And thus far, that's been the only time they've got to compete this year. But they're very, very hopeful for an opportunity at the NACTA contest in April in Kansas coming up here. So we've been preparing kind of silently here. Haven't been able to travel a ton, but proud of these kids because they've still been working very, very hard, even knowing that this year's presented some challenges. And I'm really, really excited about their growth that I've seen from day one to now. So just to briefly introduce those 15 team members, they represent six states. So we got a lot of diversity this year. Brooke Byers is from Sibley, Illinois. Dylan Chalene is from North Henderson, Illinois. Adam Doyle is from Waterloo, Illinois. Carson Fay is from New Windsor, Maryland. Emma Freebairn comes from Serena, Illinois. Sheridan Hank comes from Aledo, Illinois. Catherine Horrell comes all the way from Merced, California. Braden Lackenmeyer comes from Tappan, North Dakota. Tanner Mickey, a little bit closer to home, from Taylorville, Illinois. Will Oakes comes from Newton, Illinois. Sky Shoemaker comes from Hayworth, Illinois. Jarrett Tharp is also from Newton, Illinois. Katrina Tucker from Hopkins, Michigan. Paige Van Dyke from Louisville, Illinois. And our lone Hoosier on the team, Drew Webster from Crawfordsville, Indiana. So those 15 students make up our freshman team. They have been an absolute pleasure to work with so far. I'm very excited about their potential, particularly as we look forward to their sophomore year next year when we anticipate a much more normal year in terms of travel opportunities. So thank you guys. It's been good to work with you on that standpoint. I'm looking forward to a great year coming up. Kind of moving on to the sophomore team now, and obviously this is you know, sophomore years when we really get some of those chances to get out and compete at national contests and really hit the judging circuit hard. And I'll just kind of preface this and say that, you know, at the beginning of the school year this fall, if you would have made me bet money that we would have got to a single contest this year with some of the restrictions that we were faced with and some of the challenges that we were presented with, I don't know if I would have taken that bet. It didn't look very good at times. And I want to say first and foremost, thank you to our administration, particularly John Aldhouse, for his diligence and working hard when he didn't have to make sure we got every chance we could. And there were some disappointments along the way, but there was a lot of surprises along the way too, in terms of chances to travel and compete. So I want to thank administration, particularly John, for just their willingness to work with us this year and understand that, you know, for these sophomores, this is really kind of their season. You know, there's no putting it on hold. It's, you know, really challenging to sit out a year. So they worked hard to make it as normal as possible and give as many opportunities as possible. So our sophomore team this year has 9 members from 4 states. Those members come from Indiana, Illinois, Michigan, and California. Team, given the circumstances, has had a very strong season. Finished 6th at Kansas City, and we win cattle at the American Royal. 7th place finish at the North American in Louisville. Team was reserved high overall at the Tree Lane contest, winning pigs and reasons at that particular event. Recently just had a top 5 finish, 4th overall at the San Antonio Stock Show a week or two ago there, and proved to be a great preparation event for hopefully an opportunity here at Houston at the end of March. So my compliments to these kids, because there's been times when it hadn't looked great in terms of the chances of what's going to happen and those travel allowances coming up, and they have always kept their heads down and worked hard and focused to get better. And for that, I'm forever thankful for them. And I'll always remember that about this team. Through even some of the toughest situations, they kept a work mentality, and I'm very appreciative of that. They come from very diverse and successful stock backgrounds, and yet even on top of that, more impressive perhaps is their commitment to academic success. Collectively, those 9 boast just under a 3.5 GPA, a great average. So very, very focused and driven in the classroom to make sure business is taken care of there, and we appreciate that as well. I'll go ahead and introduce some of these or these 9 team members and tell you a little about where they're from and give you a couple highlights. So first up would be Nate Brookshire, be our lone California native there, our West Coast native on the team. Woodland, California is where he calls home. Got a sheep background is what he would come from. Had a very good year. He's been the top 10 overall at the American Royal in San Antonio with some other highlights along the way. He plans to transfer to an undecided university to continue his education. Next up would be Zach Klein. Zach Klein comes to us from Allenton, Michigan. Very good show pig background. Got a lot of passion for the show pig industry. He plans to transfer to either Western Illinois University or to Iowa State University. Next up is McKenna Green. McKenna is the closest to Lakeland here, is where she calls home, in Arthur, Illinois, one of our in-district students. Comes from a competitive show hog background, has been a solid contributor this year, just recently had a really nice day in reasons at the San Antonio Stock Show. She's undecided in terms of where she wants to transfer. Tara Hummel from Cabrillo, Illinois, north part of the state there, comes from a very competitive, successful, and well-known show goat background. Tara, in terms of highlights, she was in the top 10 overall at Tree Lane. She was tied for 10th, I believe, in reasons at the Patriot in Abilene, Texas there in February, there a bit ago. And she also won sheep at the North American International at Louisville. So definitely some individual highlights for Tara throughout this year. She's undecided in terms of where she wants to transfer as well. Next up is Cody Nodal. Cody's from Fillmore, Illinois, comes from a strong cattle background, strong Simmental interest there. Cody's been in the top 5 overall at Tree Lanes contest, at the Patriot contest, and then I believe maybe all but one has been at the top 10 in cattle at every contest that he has competed in, along with a tremendous day in other species at Abilene and Tree Lane as well. So had a very, very solid year for Cody. He plans to transfer to an undecided university as well. Emma Metzger will be our other in-district student this year. She hails from Charleston, Illinois, cattle background there, Simmental and show steer interest. Emma plans to transfer to Southern Illinois University with aspirations of being an ag teacher, and we wish her luck as she goes on that path. Sawyer Schliff would be next. Sawyer comes from El Paso, Illinois. Family's known for producing some really high quality purebred cattle, but Sawyer's also got a pretty strong show pig interest. Been a very, very solid contributor for the team this year, a very good stock mind, and been a great honor to work with him. He He plans to transfer to an undecided university as well. Brianna Ulmer then comes from Greenville, Illinois, about an hour or so away from campus here. Grew up showing competitive pigs and cattle, and came in with not a lot of judging experience, but really has shown a tremendous amount of growth and has experienced some success here as we've got towards the latter part of this sophomore year, and really worked hard to make up on the learning curve, and have seen a lot of progress there from her. She plans to transfer to the University of Illinois to continue her judging career in education as well. Delaney Vickery then, from Huntington, Indiana. Delaney has a very, very strong show pig background. She's involved in that industry very, very, very heavily. Delaney has plans to transfer to Oklahoma State University post Lakeland. So if you would, just if you see those students, just congratulate them on a good year and wish them luck on the next step. If you notice, we got a lot of undecideds, and I think that's fairly standard. But at the same time, I think they've got some decisions to make, and that's okay. If I had to, you know, 9 for 9 of them plan to transfer on to universities, and if I had to make a guess, they'll end up being spread out pretty broad. So that's totally fine. But we wish all of them luck as they make that decision. But even more so in the meantime here, we want to wish them luck as they prepare for their final contest of the year at the Houston Livestock Show and Rodeo. So with that said, to wrap up the judging team portion, I've got a couple of awards to present. First award we want to present here is the Phil Rinker Memorial Award. And this is a scholarship award that's given to recognize the sophomore livestock judging student who has totaled the highest scores in beef cattle judging at all of the contests throughout their sophomore year. So Phil Rinker was from Strasburg, Illinois, and he was a member of the 0405 judging team here, was an avid Simmental breeder and beef cattle enthusiast. Unfortunately, a farming accident took Phil from us too early, and this award was made possible by Phil's family and his Lakeland judging teammates to commemorate Phil's contributions to the beef cattle industry. The winner of this year's Phil Rinker Memorial Scholarship for Beef Cattle Judging from Fillmore, Illinois, is Mr. Cody Nodal. So, Cody, congratulations. Second award we like to give and present here this evening is the Jordan Fletterjohn Memorial Award. Jordan was from Botkins, Ohio, originally. He was a member of the 2013-14 Lakeland College Livestock Judging Team. Avid show goat and club lamb breeder and enthusiast, was very, very paving a path for himself in the industry, even at his time in college. Unfortunately, he was taken too early from us a couple years ago in an automobile accident. And to commemorate Jordan's contributions to the small ruminant industry, a new memorial award we established last year for the first time. And this award consists of a perpetual plaque that hangs in the Ag Division hallway that recognizes the sophomore livestock judging student who totaled the highest scores in sheep and goat judging at all of the contests they attended throughout their sophomore year. Very, very tight race this year. Over 1,500 points possible, I think, is what I calculated from in the sheep and goat divisions from the contests we've attended. And less than 10 points separate the top three, if that tells you how tight it was. But when you add it all up, the winner this year, the Jordan Fletterjohn Memorial Award from Woodland, California, is Mr. Nate Brookshire. So congratulations, Nate. That wraps up the judging portion of our event. I'll go ahead and turn it over to get started on the recognition of our degree programs.
The Agriculture Business and Supply Degree Program is a workforce-ready associate's degree in an applied science. This core curriculum is designed for students planning a career in fertilizer, pest management, agribusiness sales, management, or ownership in these areas. While this degree is designed for agriculture business, it also provides transferability for Southern Illinois Carbondale, Western Illinois, and Illinois State Universities. Students receive hands-on experience in the classroom, real-life knowledge in internships, an advantage in the job market, and a unique chance to network through these opportunities. Here are the names of the graduating sophomores in this degree program: Brooklyn Bahar, Mallory Bergner, Mason Campbell, Bailey Cox, Aaron Forlines, Madeline Hansen, Dalton Lawless, Janie Nyhart, Dawson Phillips, Trenton Pennell, Austin Sloan, Jeffrey Stoltz, Faith Williams, and Drew Giebert. Congratulations, sophomores. This program is coordinated by Mark Niemerk, who is the agronomy instructor and farm manager here at Lakeland College, who will now speak more on our program.
Thank you, Mallory. Before announcing the award recipients of the Ag Business and Supply majors, I would first like to thank everyone for choosing to come to Lakeland College. This has certainly been a challenging year for students and staff alike. I think all of you should be commended on your effort and for your commitment to completing your degree during these difficult times. With that being said, I would now like to announce the award recipients for the Ag Business and Supply majors. We're going to start off with the High GPA Award. This is one that is very easy for us to select because it's simply based on academics. This year's recipient comes to us from Mauquia, Illinois, and is Mr. Drew Giebert. Great job, Drew. So now for the difficult part, we need to select the Outstanding Ag Business and Supply student. This is difficult because it's not based solely on academics. Other things like class participation, the attitude of the student, the dependability of the student, the leadership qualities of a student would all come to play in making the selection. To give you an idea on how this process actually works, we'll sit down and evaluate every student within the major. And then we'll select the top five or six, or at least what we believe to be the top five or six. And then we'll kind of pick those apart to try to break down to only one student. Again, very, very trying time for us. While we like giving the award, it's one that puts a lot of stress on us. After a lot of deliberation, we have selected our outstanding ag business student to be Miss Mallory Bergener from Mauquia, Illinois. Very well done, Mallory. Congratulations. And now I would like to introduce Kevin Coe to make some comments about the Diesel and Ag Power Technology program.
Ag Power Tech is designed to prepare students as a professional technician in ag and diesel machines. This program develops students in skill in diagnosing and repairing diesel fuel system, electrical system, engines, and transmission for ag machines. You can choose between certificate or associate program. The both program makes you ready for getting a technician job professionally. Before Ag Power Tech, I knew nothing and had no experiences. With the program at Lakeland College, I'm now experienced and ready to get my hands dirty. As I'm not from here, faculties always make sure that I understand everything, as well as they make me included, and they make me feel included and welcomed. My experience at Lakeland College is very special and unforgettable. Are you ready to get dirty? This is the major you're looking for. Here are graduating sophomores this year: Nick Knowles, Marcus Neal, Kevin Coe. Now, I would like to introduce Udi Reinhardt to make some comments for Ag Power Tech.
As the instructor for the Diesel and Ag Power program, it's been a joy to work with the students that I had this last 2 years. And I want to commend the students for sticking with the program and all the adversity that's happened in the last year. I know it's not been very easy, and it's been kind of difficult and restrictive. But yet, at the same time, these boys are very ambitious, and I know they're going to go places that with the ambition and the ability to keep treading through the whole thing. So along with that, I did teach some other classes with other ag students, and I want to commend all of them for all their efforts in sticking with this. I would like to introduce the high GPA this year for the Ag Power program, and that was Nicholas Knowles. And for the most outstanding student for the Diesel and Ag Power program, I selected Kevin Coe as my student for that. He put forth a lot of effort, extra effort. A lot of people in his internship seemed to really appreciate all the extra work and effort he put into it. And one of the most significant changes from the start to the end. So Kevin Coe's our outstanding student, and wish them all well.
Hello, I'm Jacob Loffenberger, a sophomore agricultural production and management student. The Ag Production core curriculum is designed for those seeking a career in agricultural production, farming, ag production sales, and management or ownership in these areas. While the curriculum is designed for ag production, It also allows transferability to Illinois State, Southern Illinois, and Western Illinois universities. The graduates from Agricultural Production and Management, Rhett Banman, Layla Bennett, Tucker Kripe, Caitlin Gingrich, Jacob Loffenberger, Alex Prupst, Nicholas Tarr, and Garrett Tibbett. And now here's Hayden Wilder, the Ag Production and Management Coordinator, for some remarks. Thank you.
Well, thank you for introing those students, Jacob. And I would just say this Ag Production and Management group has been my first group that I've been able to see from start to finish in terms of their time at Lakeland, starting as freshmen and now graduating. And it hasn't been a huge group in terms of numbers, but I think in terms of the impact that they'll leave on their respective industries, I think it'll be substantial. And they've been a lot of fun to work with for sure as I've gotten started here in my role with the college. Got a couple of awards to present now relative to the Ag Production and Management major. First off, a high GPA award. And our high GPA award this year for the collective time at Lakeland and the Ag Production and Management program goes to Ms. Caitlin Gingrich. So Caitlin, congratulations. We also select an outstanding student in each division each year. And this is going to be a student who not only excels in the classroom, but also takes that extra step to get involved in some extracurriculars to really help out others and just generally bring a positive feel to the Lakeland Ag Department. Several students we really discussed for this award this year, but we did come to an agreement that there was one young man that was very deserving. Our Ag Production and Management Outstanding Student this year is Mr. Alex Prupst. So Alex, congratulations to you. With that, I'd like to introduce Alex Johnson to start with your horticulture major.
Hi, I'm Alex Johnston. I'm in the Horticulture Production and Landscape program. I'll be talking a little about our program, and I will also be announcing this year's graduates. Within our degree in Horticulture Production and Landscape, you can obtain a certificate or your associate's in applied science. After graduation, students have an option for transfer to Illinois State or Southern Illinois universities. The horticulture industry continues to grow and is in need of students trained in areas including greenhouse management, landscape design, landscape construction, turf management, and nursery tree production. Our program provides valuable internship experiences in many of the horticulture industry areas. Now I will be announcing this year's graduates: Faith Camfield, Dalton Denton, Mackenzie Foudy, Christine Haney, Maxwell Neal, and myself, Alex Johnston. At this time, our horticulture instructor and program coordinator will be talking a little more about our program.
All right, thank you. I guess what I'd like to do first is just say thank you to my horticulture students for this year. I know it's been a challenging year, and we haven't got to do as many of the field trips and things as we've done, but we still get to build a few patios out the back and do a few things in the greenhouse. Tonight, I'd like to talk about two outstanding ladies that I have in my program that are finishing up their careers here. First is the high GPA, and that goes to a young lady who got into the horticulture program after getting her ag business degree. She went to Belize with us as a group and then kind of came back and wrapped up her horticulture degree and did all that, kept the GPA up even after having a really bad wreck. So this year I'd like to congratulate my highest GPA horticulture student is Christy Haney. Another young lady that I'm proud of in my program that's graduating here is a student that's very quiet, doesn't win the award for being the most loudest student in the class, so to speak, but she really applies. I appreciate how she applies everything we talk to, think it through, and just kept plugging away, and I think will really go places in her future. So for this year, my outstanding horticulture student is Alex Johnson. To wrap up, I guess I'd like to introduce Zach Lott of the John Deere Tech program.
A new generation of farm equipment demands a new generation of service technicians. To meet this demand, John Deere Company has created the John Deere Tech program and has selected Lakeland College as one of the limited number of North American sites. The John Deere Tech program is a two-year ag mechanics program designed to upgrade the technical competence and professional level of the incoming dealership technician. The curriculum is designed by John Deere and Lakeland College and leads to an associate in applied science degree. The program involves attending classroom lecture, and lab experiences on John Deere products and a unique opportunity for students like myself to work at a John Deere dealership. The total program is completed in 5 semesters, or roughly 21 months. Each specialized subject is studied in the classroom and lab on campus, and then followed by related work experience in the dealership. The classes listed as SOE in the class schedule section are spent at the participating dealership, gaining valuable work experience. After the dealership work experience is completed, the students return to the campus to begin another academic cycle. This rotation continues until completion of the program. The work experience at their participating dealership will relate as much as possible to the coursework just completed at the campus. Now I will list the graduating students from the John Deere Tech program. Patrick Bell from Brockton, Illinois. Wyatt Brownlee from Gibson City, Illinois. Mark Corrigan from Pontiac, Illinois. Cole Dial from Louisville, Illinois. Eli Ennis from Charleston, Illinois. Andrew Hagen from Aviston, Illinois. Stephen Holder from Raymond, Illinois. Austin Huffman from Rochdale, Indiana. Clint Krug from Wingate, Indiana. Austin LaFoon from Wingate, Indiana. Zachary Lott from Jerseyville, Illinois. Ian Lowry from Sadras, Illinois. Brady Moore from Hoobston, Illinois. Jared Phillips from Lebanon, Illinois. Max Pickle from Rochdale, Indiana. Skylar Rhodes from Mattoon, Illinois. Ethan Stoltz from Darlington, Indiana. Caden Swamberg from Pontiac, Illinois. Shane Young from Waynetown, Indiana. And now I'd like to introduce Russell New for a few comments.
Hi, my name is Russell New, John Deere Tech instructor and program coordinator for the John Deere Tech program here at Lakeland College. I would like to introduce the sophomore students who achieved a 3.0 or higher. Those students are Ethan Stoltz, Caden Swanberg, Mark Corrigan, Austin Huffman, Clint Krug, Zach Lott, Jared Phillips, Patrick Bell, Wyatt Brownlee, Cole Dial, Eli Ennis, Stephen Holder, Austin LaFoon, Ian Lowry, Brady Moore, Max Pickle, and Skylar Rhodes, along with Shane Young. I would also like to introduce the two high GPA students that we had this year. Those two students are Cole Dial and Jared Phillips. Every year we have an outstanding student. This outstanding student is a student who shows fantastic skills both in the classroom and at the sponsoring dealership. This year, the outstanding student is Cole Dial. Next, I would like to introduce Ashton Geyer from the Ag Transfer Program.
Thank you. The Agricultural Transfer Curriculum is designed for those students who are planning to transfer to a university and earn their Bachelor of Science degree in Agriculture. Your 2021 Ag Transfer graduating sophomores are Elizabeth Applegate, Bo Bennett, Riley Bridgman, Nathaniel Brookshire Thompson, Nolan Burdett, Brady Shavs, Zachary Klein, Jesse Dust, Alexis Elder, McKenna Green, Ashton Geyer, Jarrett Hardick, Aaron Harrell, Malia Hennings, Macy Heselton, Tara Hummel, Cody Nodal, Haley List, Chase Martin, Jacob Mays, Juliana Meyer, Emma Metzger, Nicholas Mitchell, Cassie Peters, Kaylee Phillips, Daniel Reedy, Dane Robertson, J.C. Schertz, Sawyer Schliff, Catherine Smith, Hannah Tappendorf, Royce Thompson, Martana Tun, Brianna Ulmer, Delaney Vickery, Jesse Voiles, Emily Walk, and Travis Wilkie. Now I would like to welcome Ryan Wildman to speak more about the Ag Transfer Program.
Thank you, Ashton. As Agriculture Transfer and Pre-Veterinary Medicine Advisor, it has been a pleasure to work with each of you over the past 2 years. Congratulations to all of our Agriculture Division graduates. I look forward to seeing the successes you have in the future. The first award that I am presenting is to the agriculture transfer student who has earned the highest GPA. This student has not only excelled academically, but has done so while being a member of the Lakeland College Livestock Judging Team, serving on the Lakeland College Student Ambassadors, had involvement in PAS, served as an officer of the Agriculture Transfer Club, and is a member of the Lakeland College Collegiate Farm Bureau. It is my honor to recognize McKenna Green as the 2021 High GPA Agriculture Transfer Student. The next award that I have the opportunity to announce is the award that goes to the Outstanding Agriculture Transfer Student. This individual has not only excelled in the classroom, but has also been involved outside of the classroom as well. This student has served on student ambassadors, been a member of the Agriculture Transfer Club, and served as a member of the Lakeland College Collegiate Farm Bureau. I am honored to announce that the 2021 Outstanding Agriculture Transfer Student is Emmalyn Walk. I now introduce Ryan Orrick, who will present the Outstanding Agriculture Student Award.
This year's Outstanding Agriculture Student has been a phenomenal asset to our division. She has been active, a great student, and has a pleasant demeanor. In her 2 years at Lakeland College, she has been involved with Student Ambassadors, PAS, Ag Transfer Club, and the student representative to the Alumni Board. She plans to transfer to the University of Illinois in agriculture education in the fall, and we wish her the best. Congratulations, Hannah Tappendorf, the 2020-2021 Outstanding Agriculture Student. Best of luck.
I would now like to take this time to personally thank everyone for attending the 2021 Lakeland Agricultural Division Banquet. Highlighting the success of the students and extracurricular activities of the Ag Division truly speaks volumes to what we believe in here, and that is creating great students and even better people. This past year has tested all of us in one way or another. Each of our lives were impacted in entirely different ways, but we all still managed to make the best of the situation and come out on top. To the staff, I know this past year has looked nothing like any of you have anticipated, and it's your ability to adapt and overcome that is truly second to none. You guys made Zoom calls more interesting than I ever thought possible and made sure that we could attend in-person classes with any chance we got. At the same time, you also advocated and helped organize our clubs that mean so much to all of us. So I personally would like to take the time to thank each of the agricultural staff and faculty that make our Ag Division truly the best in the nation. Without each of you, there is no way we could be what or who we are today. Next, a special thank you goes out to the alumni and parents of students who show their utmost support for Lakeland College. And in closing, if you happen to catch a faculty or staff member, don't hesitate to say a few kind words and thank them for all of their hard work each and every day. So once again, I thank you for attending our annual agricultural banquet and cannot wait to see what the future holds for us students, as well as the Lakeland College. Thank you.